Welcome to Nance Care Garage. Today I'm excited. I got a core short shifter for the truck, and that should be really awesome. It should change the whole way you drive it. Stand by. Here's what we got. I'd like to say that we're going to unbox this together, but we're not. I already unboxed it. So it came in a U.S. postal box, just a U.S. postal box. Inside U.S. postal box was this bag, okay? And here should be the packaging, okay? Here's the packaging that it came with. That's right. So the packaging leaves a lot to be desired. However, I didn't buy it for packaging. Okay, here's the directions. It's pretty straightforward. I'm not even going to read them. It'll come with directions. Here's your longer bolts that you're going to need. These are going to go. Let's see here. Open up, you. Dang, Ziploc bags. I have to get a drug dealer to open them for me. All right. These are going to go down through here. Now, they're quite a bit longer because they're going to go in. By the way, here, this is the gasket here that comes with it. It should be in the package. They put it on here, which is good so you don't lose it. So they're going to come, and they're going to go just through like that there so that we should be able to get that in the top of the shifter housing. And there's three of them because that's all it is three bolts that hold it down. So this setup here, I don't know if you can see it, hopefully you can. There's a bar that goes through there that so that it goes back and forth. Okay, and then I'm assuming there's another bar down below or whatever to make a spring this way, which is really hard to do holding it because it's supposed to be hard to do in order to shift sideways. So that's sideways and back and forth. I don't believe that this is going to get loose and shaky like the one that Ford put in it. Mazda put in it. Whatever. This is the top. It goes on here. Looks like it fits really tight. And it does. Good. I like that. I want it to fit tight. That way, nothing will get in there. And then when I put this all over here, and I get it on there, let's just see if we can't get it on here. Little tabs on it. Looks like it was made pretty good. It's not easy to get on, which is fine. We'll get it on when we get it in the truck. And I'm glad because the other thing I wanted to do is I can see down in here. Yep, don't you go away, I need you. I can see down in here, let's see, where is it? There, if you see on the top side here, there's a little bit of grease there. So, it's got a little bit of grease in it. I'm going to put some red tacky in the top of here also, so that it has a lot of grease in it. And that'll hold really well. Anything that leaks down the bottom, since there's grease there, won't be a big deal. If it actually winds up going through, well, it's just going to go in the transmission fluid and mix with it. That's all. So that's what we got. And this will go on top of it once we fix this. First thing we're talking about is the shifter handle, shifter whatever you call it. We'll talk about this thing. This is the shifter for the truck. I did the bushing replacement, rebuilt the whole thing, and built great. Because this thing was all over the place. So, got it all nice and tight, popped this on, put the bolt in, clamped it down, and it was still all over the place. Wasn't this bad, but it was still all over the place. So, I went to the junkyard one day, and I found a truck that had stick shift in it. So I said, well, let me just pull that shifter. Okay, and I pulled it out. The reason was I had a suspicion of something. You see this line right here. Okay. I kept seeing that and thinking something's got to go in there. It just doesn't make sense that they would build something like that and put a line in there for no reason at all. When I looked up in here, I couldn't see anything in it. Of course, the outside was rusty, so I didn't notice. And then when I got the other shifter, I took one look at it, and there's a pin in there. I've started driving it out. It's right there. And we're going to put a new pin in here so that we can fix this one. Eventually, I'm going to cut this off here, and we're going to make a custom shifter for it. It's going to be pretty cool. But we got to fix that so we can use it. Right now, there we go, it worked. That's what was left of the pin. Why did that happen? A couple reasons. This ain't no gear banger. That transmission is not a gear banger, so you can't be banging gears. You could shear that pin off. More than likely, it was when they changed, they had a custom handle on here. So the original handle is glued onto this. It's not threaded on, you know, like a regular shift knob and whatever. It's actually glued onto there. So in order to get it off, there's a couple different ways. The best way is to take a pair of pliers under it and just kind of tap up on it, but take the thing out before you do anything. Most likely what happened was it was in and they want to take it off. They put a pair of channel locks on it and just twisted the heck out of it. When they did, they snapped the pin. So that pin has to be in there. I bought pins. However, it just ever so slightly too big. And I kind of don't really want to go back and do it again. It's more than ever so slightly too big. It's too big. So what we're going to do is we're going to grind this down. But we want to keep it round. So how are we going to do that? First, I'm going to just put it in here. I'm going to take right to the end there because I just want it to stay there. Tighten down on that good so it stays right where it is. And it's just fairly straight. Fairly straight. And now I'm going to grab this flap disc here. Just like that. And boy howdy, I found a pair. They are really dirty. I gotta get by Harbor Freight, Horrible Freight, and get another couple pair. They're cheap enough, I just keep a bunch of them. Alright, I'm gonna put that on there. Here's what we're gonna do. Start the flap disc and get this going like that. Not quite that fast. Let's take this down to the lower speed. Yeah. All right, that goes in and stops. Hopefully it's enough. To hold. That's the other thing you gotta make sure it's gonna hold. Pop it right there. Okay. I probably went too far. There's a guarantee I went too far. All right, let's see if we can knock it out a little bit. All right, got an idea. Yeah, I do. Oh, we've got ideas.
The pin's leaning a little too far, so I'm just gonna grab the Dremel here, and we'll just Dremel this bad boy out. Just need to make it a little bit shorter than it is in order for it to go down over top of that shifter stalk. I don't know what the heck to call it. This is a shifter stick, that's a shifter stalk, stick stalk, I don't know. So just cut it down a little bit and then we'll be good.
Well, I forgot to turn the damn cameras on. The only thing you missed was pulling the screws out of this and pulling the bellows up. All right, it's a 17 bolt, I thought it was. So this wedge in here holds the stick on. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna take this out of here. Taking that bolt off of there. This thing's really getting on my nerves. There, and that's gonna come off like that. Now, I want to say, Ford, you had really a better idea here, because now I'm putting the nut on this side, but this is a Mazda transmission. Granted, Ford owned them, so Ford might have had something to do with this. I don't like the way this stick is put on here in the first place, but at least wise they gave you a way to bring that wedge out of there without having to get in and bang on it and hammer on it and stuff. You put that bolt on that side, nut on that side. There we go. Now, I'm gonna tighten down on it. Try to tighten down on it. It's gonna be difficult, of course. Let me move just a little bit. There we go. That wedge out of there just like that. Now it's here. I'm gonna have to crawl under the truck to get it, and we're gonna grab that. Once you got that, this should come right up off there like that. So what you have is this wedge goes in here. Nope. Wedge goes in here and goes across once I get it in there, right? That will go across there and tighten that down. I might have it backwards. Let's see here. How's it go? Dang it. Dang thing goes right in there once you get it in. There it is, like that. I'm going to go right through there, and then you put this nut on this side and tighten it up. That's how that works. So it's actually a pretty good idea. Whoever came up with it. Hope I don't have to go looking. Let's see if this has one that'll fit it. Right there. Yep. Yeah. Do that there. That's three, and it comes out like that. Then this here is supposed to stay down on there, and it didn't. I might not have put it on right either. I guess it goes under there. Yeah, that's probably what it is. Dummy me, I didn't put it on right, so no big deal. Get rid of it. All right, and then this cap comes right off of there like that. All right, now that looks just like another stalk, don't it? All right, out of there, we have the spring. All right, this was put tension onto this bushing, which we will no longer need. Actually, I think we do need that bushing. We're gonna see. All right, and then we pull that out, and that's what we got. And there's another bushing just like that one in there. Short-throw shifters can be a little bit of a mystery. I won't put together a graphic, but we'll see if I do or not. This is the original one out of the truck. Okay, this is the long throw shifter, okay? This is my pivot point. This is the one I got. This is a short throw shifter. The pivot point is right here. So, you notice how much longer that shaft is than this one? The reason for that is, now, if I put this on here, let's see, so I can move it. I put this on here, okay? I can move it here to here. So this is the whole throw of the shifter here. The thing is, if that is there, okay, and our pivot point is here, if I put this at the same distance, basically, this comes to here. So if I put them together, you see at the same, let's see if I could do this here. With this short throw shifter, pivot points being about the same, this is here, and this is here. Move this, I want to make sure you see this. I have these shifters at basically the exact same level. All right, the only difference that it's making is this. Make sure my pivot point's right. If this shifter is in the same position, then it's right here, not here. If our pivot points are at the same place, which they are, you can see that's moved the rails further than that has. That's what makes it a short throw. Maybe I can make some kind of graphic up to show you how that's done. But
so if you look on the left side here, you'll see these are the shifters. The long shifter, which is the one that came out of the truck, and the short shifter, which is the new one. And the bottom line says pivot point. That's where they both pivot. You notice that the short shifter has a longer tang on the bottom than the long shifter does. And if you look at the diagram on the right, you can see where the pivot points, I have the pivot points on both. When that longer tang moves the gear to the proper position, if you notice, the short shifter on the top side doesn't move it much. It's basically just because we've moved the pivot point and we put a longer tang on the bottom. And that's how it works. I hope this makes sense to you.
That's basically it. So this having a longer stalk, it's fitting tight, which I like. Come on out of there, you. See how it fits in this one. Just curious. And that one, see that moving like that? This is the one that I fixed. It's about the same movement, so not that much difference. Nope. But the stalk, the wedge should take that up. Problem is, if you don't have that pin in there, the wedge won't take it up. So that's what we have. And this is that shifter I was talking about. The shifter knob is glued on there, and you have to knock it off. And if you grab it and twist it really hard, you're gonna bust that pin. Yep, okay. We'll put that right there. And that's what we got. Now we got to install this. I remember what I said about the red tacky. This is good grease. I'm going to pack this down in here a little bit more. I don't want this to wear out. I don't know if it will, but if it's well greased, it'll have less of a chance of wearing out. All right, pack that in there, and I might just pack the, and I might just pack that billows with it too, but we'll see. It appears that we need those pins out of there. Okay, and they are not wanting to cooperate. There we go. I guess they get a little worn. These are the pins that it pivots on. Chewed them up. Interesting. Sorry about the light. I got another one. Okay. Got tore up too. It's interesting. All right, so up on top of here, where our gasket's gonna seal. Hope I put that in neutral. That fits in there pretty tight. One problem I'm having with it. Got this washer here, and we got another one. I'm thinking we have to turn these so that it seals these up. Or maybe I should put silicone in it, actually, probably. Okay. After reading the directions, and I know what I said. We got to fill these holes with RTV. So I got this good high temp stuff here that I've been using, because we're no longer going to use these pivot holes. Now, if for some reason we need to change it back, there's nothing to get that out of there. I'm going to fill those holes up there because we don't want them leaking. And I'd like to see it come through just a little bit. There we go. That's enough. That's full. That off of there, like that, and come to this side here. That's full off there. Infamous 10. They're quite short for this, what we're doing here, but make sure they don't cross thread. And this is just me. I would use quarter inch drive. They're small bolts. Also, in case we don't want it to go down too far, in case there's a problem. So with the quarter inch drive, you're not going to be forcing things enough, because you break drive before you force it enough to break something. And it's going down further than I thought. It seems to fit in that hole pretty tight, and that's good, I guess. Just keep going around it. Okay, very tight fit. It's what I like, it should be. All right, now, get this to pop over there. Come on, you, it's like that. That fits in there nice and tight. know, the edge over the front. Okay, got an idea. I can't grab anything because it's all so greasy. I wonder what we'll do. Let me get that back over the front part. There. Bring it around. This right here. Just like that. Actually, the grease did the trick. Not quite. I need to grab this tab right here. Right there. Yeah, just the tab, not the metal. There it is. Alright, and that is now on there. That is all sealed up and it's got grease in it. That is a good thing. Yep. Alright. Push that off of there. Alright. The shifter stalk, you can go back down on there. Just like that there. All right, we're gonna take this sucker here and we'll take a bolt off of this side. And we're gonna stuff this thing back through the other side of that. That, once we find the right place. In a certain way. Right there. There we go. Just like that. And I'm going to put this on here. I'm going to tighten it up. You cannot be... You must be kidding me. Oh my goodness. This is amazing. Thing shifts like a Mustang. Almost. I think that's going to be awesome. Okay, if you haven't seen my little tricks, this is one. Awl or a pick or something, put it through that hole there, and I'm going to look down here, I'm going to find that hole there. Okay. I'm going to line it up, and I'll put that straight down, and I'm going to hold it right there. Put the screw in. Come on, get in there, you. Can't move right. You gotta hold that one down so that you get everything right. Screw right there. There we go. That one in there. The others theoretically should line up. Theoretically. It would appear that one did. Down on that side, but then we'll go down on this side. Why? What's there? That down like that. There. What I'm going to do is put a couple more screws in this thing here because I know that it leaks, which is annoying. In the summertime, you're on a long trip, you got the air conditioner blasting, and it works, but doesn't work great. Come to a stop and you freeze.
So what I didn't finish saying was when you come to a stop, you get real cold in the truck because the air conditioner was blowing like crazy. And then when you start rolling again, it would warm up. And what it was we've got air coming in through this floor boot. I can't get it to seal up right. So what I'm going to do to fix that is we're going to make a steel plate to go down over top of it that'll hold it flat to the floor the way I want it.
All right, let's see. I got here stick gauge steel from my dryer that took a crap on me. All right, so right here. I'm going to grab his cutoff wheel. I'm going to put gloves on. I'm working with the sharp stuff. Glasses. All right. Wrong one. Use it to grind corners, but I got to cut it. Yeah. What I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna score the line until I get a good line, then I can follow it. I don't know what the gauge on this stuff actually is, but it's very thick, which is what I want. Here's the deal with anything like this. Like I said, this was an old dryer. Dryer was done. I cut the sides up because I can use this metal to fix rust. In fact, this stuff is way thicker than what's on the car. So this will make a really nice rust patch. Now I got plenty of this metal. All right, now, next thing I want to do, I actually want to get this to be right about to there. So let's see what we got here. Grab the pin. I'm just going to eyeball this because it only needs to be eyeballed. Here. If I was cutting a panel for a car, I'd be way more exacting. But it's not a panel for a car. It's basically a huge washer to hold this dang thing down the way I want it held down. Yeah. I think this will be the way to fix this. Okay. Now, we got that to go over there. That'll hold that down nice. Yeah, it will. That's going to be awesome. That's going to work out just like I'd hoped it would. All right, now. This is not dry, not by a long shot, but I'm racing the weather again. Let's just gonna pop that right in there like that. There. Now, I'm gonna take a screw. I wonder if this is magnetic. I have not magnetized that. Dang it. All right. Wedge up there good and tight. Ah! Torque the specs as usual. German torque. Good and tight. All right, this end can come down on there. That for now, until we get the other one made. and it's pretty much gonna just drill into the carpet. That's nice. That's amazing. Glad I waited to make that custom shifter. So, when I do make the custom shifter, I'm gonna bring this down to here so that this should be first, and this should be second. This should be third. This should be fourth. Yeah. That's exactly what I'm gonna do. Yep. We're gonna give it a different angle. All right, so I wish you could see this shifter. I don't think you can really see anything anyway, but the shift on this thing is like a Mustang. It just really simple. It's really close. So I gotta tell you something. This is a good buy. It's only about 2.25. And the damn thing's awesome. It just, it changed the whole truck. Changed driving the whole truck. It's really a good one. So what I'm gonna sit here and tell you right now is if you wanna upgrade your shifter, this is the way to do it, the core shifter. It works great on the Mazda transmission here. And till next time, see ya.